everybody. I just wanted to show you something I got. And I know I'm not framed very well, but I haven't showered in a couple days, so you're not missing much by not seeing my face much. But I got this bag from somebody on a Facebook page, a bushcrafting trade page. I believe he makes them himself. This one is coyote brown. I wanted the multi-cam, but he was out of the material at the time, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to be ordering another one after seeing this. This is a haversack with a nice, generous, nice buckle. You can see there, double overstitching. It may not be the most perfect straight line in the world, but that's all right. That's how I know it's handmade. Somebody took the care and attention to put this together right for me. You've got extension for the strap if you need it longer. Neat little gadget you got here is folded in is a Velcro retainer. So as you bundle that up, you can use the Velcro retainer and keep your tail line all nice and secure. Got two clasps on the outside here with, again, lots of tag lines so you can get in there and make those longer. I'm going to go relatively quick here, folks, because my battery's getting low. I believe this is waterproof, a dermal water repellent sprayed on here. The actual material, I think, is 500 denier cordura. Got the overflap with, again, generous amount of stitching on both sides. It's going to stay together for a while. A strip of about 3.5 inches by about 1.25 inches of good Velcro. On the outside, we have the first pocket, also Velcroed on. And again, double line of stitching, so it's going to be sturdy. It's the same size as this pouch here, white on the inside. Okay. And if we flip that closed, there's another pouch right here. So we've got this whole packet as well, open top. If we look to the inside, you can see generous stitching again on the stress points for the shoulder strap, both sides. And I'll open it up here. You can see inside, it's a fairly roomy pack. It's actually smaller than I thought it was, but in my mind's eye, I guess I thought it was a bit bigger, but it's going to work out just fine at this size. There's a pocket in here with no top on it. So that's what it looks like on the inside. That's what the back of it looks like. You see the stitching around for the pockets and such. Box stitching here again. I'm going to put a bunch of gear in it, and then I'm going to come back to you and review just to see some of the things that I would suggest that I might take on a day hike that in an emergency might turn into an overnighter. Stick with me, folks. I'll be right. All right, so I packed the bag up with a handful of items. It's just what I had laying around. I've got a couple other bags here at the camp, but I just took some stuff out here and there for some suggestions for items. But you can see that it's definitely not strained for space. It's definitely covert. You could walk around pretty much any town, USA or Canada, and not get a second look about this, as the current metrosexuals wearing these man purses and satchels and stuff. So you can see it's quite not a burden. I'm guessing, because I don't have my scale with me in the field today, it's probably about 6 to 7 pounds. So I'm just going to unpack everything, and you can see I figured out that tether, got it folded back up. I'm going to unpack everything and show you what I've got in here. So I live in bear country, so I don't encounter bears very often, but just in case, what I've usually got on me if I'm hiking is a can of bear spray. So that's out, up and at them, rapidly deployed, and you can attempt to make the bear go away, or at least you can taste a little spicy, so if the bear likes spicy food, you're working with them. So outside pocket. Good Velcro. So stuff I want to get at often. My bright neon green compass. And because I know somebody's going to ask, it is a Brunton Classic. And I think parts of it glow in the dark, but whatever. I have my backup compass. A little compass from Silva. It's also got a thermometer on it. I have my pace beads. So working with the compass, you can figure out your distances and such. And that's it for that little pocket. Okay. Second line of defense. Old Fatwood. Thank you, Karen Chakey. You can check out her channel. I'll put the link down here somewhere. She and I have traded a few different products back and forth, and she's a good friend to have. I've got a flashlight today. It's a Phoenix E21. If you're sensitive to light, hang on here. That's low beam. That's high beam. That's off. That's all it does. It's waterproof too. Whatever, 2 meters, 6 feet or so, drop proof from a few feet, but I don't abuse my stuff, so it's in good shape. I've had this for like 3 years now. I got two of them. And great little light, uses a couple of double A's, and there's a pouch that's on one of my Molly rigs that it slides into real easy from Condor. It's a Phoenix E21, if you didn't hear me the first time. On a carabiner, just because you never know when you need a carabiner, those flint spark tool. That's the usual, what is it now? Light my fire spark tool. I'll spark it because everybody likes to see sparks. There you go. We're on top of my 100% wool blanket, by the way, so that was completely safe on the set. Do we have something else from the guy who made this for me? in this pouch, which is very lightweight. I haven't weighed it, but it's very lightweight. I have a 5x7 silicone nylon tarp, which is really cool. Silni. It's got a lot of tie-outs, just like his attention to detail in the bag. You can see all the box stitching in here. Very sturdy. It's very light. And it's a generous 5x7. It wasn't something I was really looking for, but when we started making some trade offers, it was something that came up as an offer, and I thought, you know what, for the hell of it, I'll take it. I'm surprised by the lightness of it. I'm curious about the durability, but I can't tell you that until I use it a few times. But the stuff sack is great. It's a nice tough Cordura. It's olive drab, so I'll get some use out of that, and I'll come back to you with another video someday. So far, we've barely cracked the first couple of pouches. We got a pair of good old leather mitts. We've got, hey, there you go. The SS bottle, the SS cup. This is a Cool. And with the Cool, you can see the lid here. I bought some aftermarket lids from Cool. They clip open and do that. The nice thing about this bottle, depending on how tight the lid is today, is I can take it apart and, oh, that's what I forgot, my fish mouth openers. You can hang the fish mouth openers in there, hang it in a fire, or take it out of a fire. I don't actually have them with me because they're in a kit that I've got at home. So that can be full of water or not. Right now it's probably half full because I've been drinking on it all day. You want to process some firewood? Well, here you go then. One silky pocket boy, and I think this is 130, which means the blade length is 13 centimeters. So for you guys who don't know metric, you can find yourself a website that does conversions pretty easy. If I have the time when I'm editing, I'll put it in there for you. It's about 5 inches. We have, well, in Canada, we call it toque or a toque. Call it a watch cap, fleece, lightweight, scrunches up real good, easy to hide somewhere. We have matches, self-explanatory. We have, this is just the knife I happen to have with me. It's a bit bulky for this bag, but it's my Gerber Prodigy. So, I've used this a lot in the field. Anybody who's watched one of my videos, you would have seen this around. It has Molly attachable loops on the back, which is one of the reasons I bought it at first. But overall, I just like it. It's a good balanced knife. It's got a good thickness. It's strong, it's sturdy. It's a full tang design, good rubber handle. I don't like this glass breaker on the back, and I've been meaning for about 2 years to round out that back from that triangle because I've caught my elbow on it a few times and not gouged myself, but I got a little cut out of it. So, Gerber Prodigy, good deal for a knife. Partially serrated, I mentioned, and partially not serrated, so you can get the best of both worlds. We have Frontier Pro water filter. So this is like the, there's some yahoos in the background. Apologize for that. This is a great little tool as well. You've probably seen it in some of my other videos, but you can take this, get the cap off, put this on there, super easy, just like I was showing you. Stick that in pretty much any water source that's bacteria or virus impaired, and you should come out with clean water. It doesn't disinfect pollutants and such, none of the filters do, and they rarely mention that, but it will take out your biological pollutants. And it's got an adapter here for Camelback, so you can run it in line, do that, and you pull off the cap there. There's some other gizmos that you have to do, but it's pretty straightforward. I like it. I got a couple of them. For a compact bag like this, they're perfect. Put that over there. All right, still getting more stuff. The cover. We have a SOL, which I think stands for something else, S-O-L, but survive outdoors longer. 91 grams for your ultra lighters. So like a 1 to 2 person, a little heavier duty than your 99 cent Mylar emergency blanket. Still going. Batteries for the flashlight. There's 3 in there because I put one of the smoke alarm in the trailer. Otherwise, that holds 4 AA's or 4 AAA's. And here's something that every Canadian's going to love. Crown Royal bag. Now, this is generally reserved in Canada to hold your letters for your Scrabble game. I think every household's got one. But I've taken this a step further, and I brought it outdoors with me. And what I've got it in it, is a stainless steel Emberlin in not just one Ziploc, aka water container, food container, etc. But 2, this is the original one that it comes with. So that's a really compact stove. You can see that unlike some reviewers, I've actually used it. So I like it, works well, it's kind of warped, but with a little wiggling, it goes together pretty easy. And you know, it's whatever, I'm trying not to get too filthy from it. These are the 2 stays that go across the top of it. You guys want me to put it together? Nah, I'll do that in a different video. You've seen it before. We're getting a little long in the tooth already here. And with the Emberlit, and the water bottle, and the cup, and some fire, what you can do is cook yourself some food. So I have here a spicy sausage pasta from Natural High. I haven't actually tried this one. I don't know if it's any good or not, but I'm hopeful. It worked for the shoot. If that doesn't work, you could try some MREs. There's imitation boneless pork rib. Doesn't that sound good? There's penne with vegetables, sausage crumbles, and spicy tomato sauce. Again, no thank you. Pork sausage patty. Yeah, I dig that. Beef ravioli and meat sauce. All right. I got all day here, folks. Penne pasta with vegetable crumbles and spicy tomato sauce. Again, all right. Vegetable lasagna. Boy, we'd be healthy. Where's the meat? Bah. Brisket entree gravy with seasoned beef brisket slices. That sounds good. Mexican-style chicken stew. No idea what to expect. Never had it. Chicken and dumplings, white meat. Perfect. Cheese tortellini in tomato sauce. Had that one. It's not bad. Beef stew. Pretty hard to screw that up. Sloppy Joe filling. Not sure what you can put it in, but probably spoon it up. Another vegetable lasagna. And the last one in this box is beef enchilada in sauce. Welcome to the world of MRE entrees. Another option for you. Beef jerky. I'm not getting paid by these guys, so there you go. Big bag of beef jerky, a couple of bucks at Costco or other cost cutter, other food source. Now you're all going to say to me, ah, I see everything. But other than this little bit of twine, and this little bit of twine, where is your cordage? I'll tell you. I just got my first 1,000-foot roll of paracord. This color is from supplycaptain.com, 1,000-foot, and it's called Anaconda, 550 Type 3 Commercial, and it's inspected by somebody with the initials MM. I'm looking forward to this product, but I'm not ready to start cutting hunks off it yet because I just bought it and I got to bring it home. But you can put in whatever amount you could fit into this package, and really, okay, food stuff was a bit of a fun, so we'll put those away. But really, what I want to show you is how much stuff you can fit in here that's useful. Could be relatively covert depending on your situation. If you're walking around the city, you want to hide this, just close it up like when we started. You don't see anything obvious. If you're walking around the bush, you might have everything in there. You might have your bear spray out on the side. You might be able to see that. You might have your compass in your hand. You might be drinking some water out of your filter. All kinds of different things, all kinds of different options. So I highly recommend this bag for trade or for purchase. His purchase price is fair, and he's got multiple things. So I'll put a link to his website. Possibly his Facebook, I'm not sure which one I've got at home, but when I get back into town, I'm going to edit this video, and I'll get a link, put it down in here somewhere, and possibly up in the, up there, just above, or maybe it's on that side, I'm not sure, where the information from the video is. So, I appreciate you watching, thanks for your support, and if you got any suggestions or comments, please leave them on the channel, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks, everybody.